Hey guys, welcome. Having a little brew sesh. Feel free to ask any questions. Welcome. Welcome guys. So today we're going to be brewing up a Colombian coffee. The varietal is a yellow Colombian. And it's actually from Colombia, which is quite funny. It's a carbonic macerated processed coffee. And it's from a producer called Sara. So yeah, I'll show you what the beans look like. Look at that. Not bad, huh? If you can smell this, it smells like grapes, boozy, similar to a natural processed. However, this is carbonic macerated, so it's got like the fermentation characteristics. We roasted the beans. So we got these off a roaster here in Melbourne called El Parch coffee roasters, and they roasted these guys for us. So yeah. All right, we're gonna be using the Hario Switch, we're gonna be using the Hario Switch, and we're actually gonna do, we're gonna be using this guy, which is the Aji Filter. This is a reusable cotton coffee filter that we sell online. We also sell like all these products. So apparently we've got Hario Switch, the server, Commandante. This is the MK4. We've got the MK3 and the MK4 available. We've just discounted the MK3 to make room for some more MK4s. We've got the, I think it's the liquid amber that's coming. So it's a really beautiful grinder. And the way you can tell is just by these, the hollowed out front here. So yeah, definitely worth checking out our website. Links in bio, we've got some sales happening at the moment. Got the EKG grinder and of course the Ukiah Pearl 2021 scales. So we've got our water coming up to about 96 degrees. So let's grind our dose and set everything up. I like to actually just dose into the Commandante cups. Just because these little glass jars, what they do is they're really good because they fit perfectly onto the Commandante. So with my single dose tube straight from the freezer, empty it out, double check that I'm weighing the correct amount of coffee. Optionally, you can use a little RDT spray. We sell these on our website as well. Pretty cheap. Give it a little spritz. Take your lid off, make sure that your grinder's on the correct grind size. Once you got your water in there, give it a little shake so that all of the beans are covered with that water. And then you can do the flip, just like that. There you go. So these amber jars, you can actually see if there's any beans left over, which there isn't. Sometimes when you got water, you'll actually have like one or two beans stuck. You can see those little dots, that's just chaff. That's not like beans, but yeah. So once you remove everything, you can still see whether anything's left over. Give it a little grind. So yeah, it's the coffee in there. Guys, feel free to ask any questions or just say hi. We're brewing a carbonic macerated coffee. So yeah. Whereabouts are you guys watching from the world? Are we all Australian or who's tuning in? that's it. Almost done. Welcome, we've got some new people. How's it going, guys? Alright, put that aside. Now I'm going to show you with this. So this is the Aji filter. These are the reusable cotton coffee filters. We recommend storing them in water, and that just slows down the growth of mildew or any other bacteria. So what I'm going to do, these tubes are perfect size for it, because you can actually, I'm not going to tip it, but this is filled with water. They are leak proof, so no water comes out unless you like squeeze it. But yeah, it's pretty hard to do. So yeah, got some water in there, filled it up so it's fully saturated. When you're ready to use it, simply just tip out the water. Like that, so we've drained it. And fish it out. You can give it a little squish. Any excess water. Just gonna pop that there for a sec. Put your tube to the side. And here it is, guys. So this is the Aji filter. Looks pretty not so attractive. Now, to correctly use these, what I recommend doing is just kind of fiddling with it until it's kind of got a cone shape in your hand, and just flip that in to your conical dripper. So you can use these on V60s, you can use them on origami drippers, cono drippers, anything with a conical brewing device. So yeah, pretty cool stuff. That's now not ready to go. We've got one more thing to do, and it's quite important. So what I recommend doing, if you've got the switch, flick it up. We're gonna have as much water in here as possible. We're gonna use hot water, and this does two things. This is going to preheat our brewer as well as set our filter in place. So I'm gonna go ahead and just dump some water in, and it will correct, it will like set the filter. So what that means is the filter right now, it's currently just sitting flat. You've got these grooves on this dripper, and it's just sitting flat. So as soon as you wet it, it's going to start to form around these grooves, and it's going to start hugging it. And that might not seem too important now, but once we start brewing, what that means is it's because we've got that seal, we've got the grooves hugged around by the filter. It's kind of like wrapped around it, if you imagine that. What that means is it's going to slow down our bypass, so water's not going to go through these grooves. Instead, they're going to be forced back into the coffee bed, and it's going to provoke a higher extraction. That's the theory. I found it to be true. So yeah, I also do this with my paper filters, but obviously with paper, it's a little bit more rigid and it's less flexible than cotton is. Give it a little swirl and drain it out. Once you've drained it out, it should be perfect. If it's not perfect, which happens sometimes, you can manually just go in here and just adjust so you've got a really nice sort of, I guess you could say, like your work, I don't know. It preps it correctly so that it's ready to brew. I guess that's what I'm trying to say. All right, now I like to use this water to preheat my cup, which I've said other times, but yeah, this is the origami sensory cup. We're just gonna dump this water in, might as well use it, give it a swirl and let it sit. Okay, pop our scales, our dripper with our filter. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna do a 50 grams each pour, so it's going to be a 5-stage brew for this coffee. Scooch it over a little bit. Now, another quick tip that I like to use when I'm brewing is once I've got my entire setup, I'm actually going to tear everything out. You don't have to do this, but I really like doing this because when I put my dose in, it's just another security. I'm going to be double checking that I've got the correct amount of coffee. So let's go. Should be about 15 grams. Perfect. 15 grams. Now, in the case that it is less than what you put into your grinder, that's your grind retention, anything around the 0.1, 0.0, whatever, that's fine. I mean, it's not, you don't have to be too particular about it, especially if you're just brewing for yourself. So yeah, if 0.1 minus plus give or take is okay. If it's really wrong, it might mean that you've got a coffee bean stuck in here somewhere and you should just keep grinding. Yeah, you can manually knock it off, take this lid. So yeah, all right, let's go for it. So 15 grams of coffee, ground by the Comandante in the Hario Switch. We're gonna open this up, tear it out again. Our water's at 97 degrees. Let's get brewing. So I'm going to start off just with 50 grams, making sure to saturate everything. And this smells amazing. It smells really good. It smells just like wine, grapes, and boozy sort of fruits. So yeah, I'm going to wait till about 30 seconds before my second pour. We're doing 5-stage pours of 50 grams. And just slowly introducing that water, bringing it up to a total of 100 grams. How easy is that? I like to just give it a little shake. Make sure everything's saturated, especially by that second pour. I think that's really important. You don't want to see any, you know, areas of dry grounds or anything like that. You want it to be completely uniform. Now, Aji filters tend to be quite fast flowing, so we're already at a minute. I'm gonna walk up to 150 grams. Super sweet, awesome stuff. You guys brewing coffee, you're just tuning in, say hi. All right, what I might do is, because it's quite quick, I'm just going to close it off. I want that water contact time to kind of be higher, especially for this coffee. I've had this coffee before and you really want that body, that texture. So just by closing it off, I mean, I guess I'm cheating in a way. Who cares? Maybe next time I'll grind a little bit finer. While I'm doing that, just got to tip out my water. My cup's preheated. I can feel it in my hand. It's warm. It's not hot, but it's warm. And I might just call that now. And for our final pour, all the way up to 250 grams. There we go. Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. And that's it. Close that off. Put that to the side. Optionally, you can weigh out your, you can weigh out your yield. So everything that's been extracted, just by tearing out your cup and pouring out your coffee. Delicious, awesome. 219 grams yielded, pretty average for 250 grams water in. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Gonna drink this coffee. Catch you later.